Yes, look at the second question. The question is, draw a line L. Draw a perpendicular to L at any point on L. First, draw a line L. This is a line L. Take a point on L. At any point on L. Okay, I am taking this point as P. And then, on this perpendicular, draw a perpendicular to L at any point on L. Suppose this is any point on L, draw a perpendicular to this point, and then on this perpendicular, choose a point x 4 cm away from L. So this is a point L, choose 4 cm away from this point. So take 4 cm with P as center, draw now. Take it as x, take it as x. After that, what you have to do? Again, through x. Draw a line M parallel to L. Draw a line M parallel to L. So this is a record one. This is a record one. First, draw a line L. Take a point P on it. This is a line L. Take a point P on it. Draw the perpendicular. Already you know how to draw the perpendicular. How will you draw the perpendicular? Yes. That is with P as center. With P as center. With P as center. Draw a semicircle. Am I right here? Now from here to here, without changing the radius, draw now. It will be 60 degree. It is 120 degree. Okay, from B. Then take more than half of this. Again, listen, with the P as center. First to draw a semicircle with any radius. Where it intersects? From this point to center, draw an arc. From this point to center, draw an arc. Then, take more than half of this distance. Take it as A. Okay, take it as A. It's the point B. It's a point C. Take more than half of BC. With B as center, draw an arc. With C as center, draw an arc. Am I right here? Now look at the point of intersection. Name it as D. Joint PD. Joint PD. First, you draw a line L. Take any point P on L with P as center. Draw an arc where it intersects the line L. Name it as A. A. Already given, right? Okay. Take it as AE. So with A as center, again draw an arc. Name it as B. Again with B as center, draw an arc. Name it as C. Now take more than half of BC. With B as center, draw an arc. With C as center, draw an arc. That arc intersects the previous arc. Where it intersects, name it as D. Okay. Now join PD. Now join PD. It is 90 degree here. It is 90 degree. Now we draw the perpendicular line on the line L at a point P. At a point P. Now, on this perpendicular, choose a point X 4 cm away from L. So this is the point L. Now take 4 cm. Take 4 cm in a compass. Take 4 cm in a compass. With P as center, with P as center, with P as center, take 4 cm in a compass. With P as center, draw an arc. Take 4 cm in a compass. With P as center, draw an arc. Where it intersects the perpendicular line, name it as X. name it as x. Now again, you have to draw the perpendicular line. Draw a perpendicular line m parallel to l through x. Again, it's very simple. See, take the radius with the x as center. Draw. Take the radius with the x as center. Draw. Am I right here? Yes. After that, where it intersects the perpendicular line, this line. Okay. From that point to center, without changing the measurement, draw. Are you getting here? Now, take more than half of this distance. From this point to center, draw another arc. That arc intersects the previous arc. Now, mark this point of intersection, join the point X. It will pass through the point X. So, this is the point of intersection. Now, it is perpendicular. Alright? Now, these two lines are what? Parallel. Can you tell me why? It is 90 degree, it is also 90 degree. These are the two lines intersected by a transversal in such a way that sum of co-integral angle on the same side of the transversal is supplementary. Therefore, these two lines are parallel. Therefore, L is parallel to M. Are you getting here? Yes. Okay. In the next video, we will start the next exercise. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.